This is the last part of the vault, and it's the last part of the first episode too. In this part, we finally get our filthy mitts on the Vactutadia. I need full health here. This level, the red part, is actually fighting the enemies instead of babysitting your son, yucks. There is kind of a boss fight at the end of this level. It is a multi-stage pantheon of monsters girding the Decanatana. Here the side boots are actually helpful. They clear out some of the monsters for you, but don't expect any help fighting me in battle. That crap is all up to Hero and his wily battle and skyinks. Okay, now I have to spariate from my friends. In the next section, I climb through many vent shafts to break into Miyamoto's treasure bin and steal his value artifacts. Okay, I break through the vent here and ride the wedge. Shake Ferris wheel right over Tesline pits. This turret is kind of boring. You just basically stand on this thing and it takes you all around the world in 80 days to end in our sanctum of gross monsters. This really takes a long damn time, I bet. Whoever designed this part got fired. Oh, but Waitino Sprung, it's shut down now, well isn't that a shame? There will never be a Decapita 2. For the world's gamers to enjoy, we just have to cherish the beloved memories John Romeo has given us all. Okay, now I have to watch for a new vent shark to climb into so I can open up the next area like a thief. There it is. Okay, I have to climb into here to throw my card right dips into the slime, which will melt me all up. Boy, right now I watch for the powerful fan, which blows into through air conditioner vent. Now I can let my seat kicks through into a final segment of the level. They can help me fight off some more baddies and make my way to a boss strategy. This crew leads me back to the Frisk Crab where I came from. I let my buddies through, and we go into a dreaded challenge of fearsome treachery. Come on, pals, let's go invade the lair of the monsters here and discover the secret of the Decatan and Mantanamet. I hate these old robots that shots missiles at you. Oh, what a pain. There are many deaths, excuse me, but nothing can stoop me now. I can almost taste the Decantanana. It tastes like success. Okay, good advice, Super Flea. What a pal, he's always looking out for me. Damn it, more molar forks to blast me with missiles. Holy crap, that smarts. You okay? This is where the boss battle will take place. I will have to go back to the Hell and Statoin and prepare for the battle of the century. It's a rumble in the jungle and the hardest fight of the game so far. This boss kind of reminds me of the end boss in Doom 2. It's a big clusterfuck of orgy for violence. Well, I only have 5 health, yet I defy an atoll I need to heal up before I take on the final shelling. My sidekicks won't be any help here. It's better to leave them outside the queue as they are much too stupid to think their way out of this predicament. Alright, it's time to take on the last task of the level. The seed cacks won't follow me into the boss room unless I specify cowardy. Tell them to, but then they just get themselves killed, so the rest get up to me now. When you step inside, I will get shocked. which will activate the pillars on the back of the room to shock you when they reach the bottom of the floor. Okay, first I will pick up this ammo, and then the first step is to kill 10 yellow plates at the top of the room. Then 3 brains in a jar opened up on the sides. You have to smash them up in the curved get. Come out of the wall. The brains are helpless. There's just one turret to protect me. You sad little Ryan Sakri. Die, you cretin. Now eat that wall of except with 2 turret gets and a big mighty giant brain to squish. This battle just gets harder and harder and damn down the Ross Crack. Tessic was. These giant shots now synergetic Ross and set you up to destruct her vision. Here now one foe them does chase me ruined. Oh, I don't think so, fella. I will shot you to death with my shoot sicklar.
It's Mishima! And he's got another Daikatana!
But that's not possible!
Oh, but it is, my dear. Just one of those conundrums that crop up when dealing with time travel and alternate timelines. You see, I was visiting the year 2030 when I sensed a disturbance in the time continuum. I realize now that what I felt was the taint of your touch on the Daikatana, sending ripples through the time stream. Fortunately for me, your presence here is merely a nuisance, and one that I can quickly dispose of at that.
Hollow words, Butcher. Your reign of terror is coming to an end.
Careful, hero. I wouldn't come any closer if I were you. These two swords are actually one and the same. If they were ever to cross or touch in any way, the world as we know it would cease to exist, and we would all be destroyed. Do you dare risk that?
You can't hide behind cheap parlor tricks forever, you coward. Why don't you face me on equal terms? Then we'll see who's the better sword master.
Naturally, your ancestry allows you to wield the Daikatana better than any man alive. Yet still, you cannot harness its true power. As I can. And with that power, I will banish the 3 of you to the ends of the earth and leave you at the mercy of the ultimate prison. Time.
No! Son of a gun! He did it! He really did it! He actually sent us back in time! Superfly? Kiko? Great. Just great. For all I know, Mishima could have stranded us in different timelines. Looks like I'm on my own.